So this is going to be a little bit of an intro into how to set up your Illustrator file, create a few glyphs, and then import them into Glyphs app. In my last video, I was talking about that Killing Eve font that I really like, and since then, I've actually made a start on that. I've got most of the characters together, so that's a really super condensed, I'm calling it like a skyscraper font because it's that condensed. And I thought that this would be a really good opportunity for me to show you how I use Illustrator and how I set up that Illustrator file for then use in Glyphs app and how I import glyphs into Glyphs app. So now we're in Illustrator and this is my template. If you want to use this template, it's available as a download from the description below. So in this template, I've got my guides, which correspond to the values on Glyphs app. And I've also made these guides, I'll just group them together, which is essentially the area that I want my font to fit into, or each glyph to fit into. So building a font, I'm gonna use one of these pieces. In fact, I'll copy both of those and then put that onto our standard layer. And let's move them to one side just so they're out of the way and change them to black. So these are the bare bones of what we will use to create most glyphs. I'm just going to show you how to build a basic shape, like what shall we do? Let's do an E. And I'll show you an A as well, something that's a little bit more complex. So to start off with the E, make sure that I copy that, duplicate into that spot, and then duplicate the horizontal rule or horizontal bar into that spot as well. Copy these into the spaces that I'm sort of allocating for those areas. And obviously these are just a little bit too long. With this font, I want it to be really, really super narrow, extremely condensed. So with this anchored up here, I'm going to change this value to 190. No, I'll go 175 because I want it to be really dramatic. On the bottom, just copy that same one. And I want the middle stem just to be a little bit shorter. So let's just try 170. Yeah, that looks pretty good. So it just sort of balances off. When you've got a middle stem like that, it kind of looks odd when it's the perfect width to the top and bottom. It needs to come in just a little bit. So that's our E. So I'm just gonna group that and pop it off to one side. And then let's try an A. So the A, I'm anticipating this not fitting into this space. So what I will do is just nudge it out, probably to, not quite to the edge of this, because this is where I'm expecting the M to sit. Maybe just about there. For me, I quite like trying things out rather than it all being super mathematical. I'd prefer it to be visually sort of appealing rather than perfectly mathematical. So to get the A shape, I'm simply just going to use the shear tool. So all I've done here is anchor the shear where it's going to move at the bottom, and then we're just using shift pull that in. So one of the things that I'm wondering about with the A is, does this top piece taper in more? Or so is that apex on this, is it going to be smaller than the bottom parts of the A, or is it going to be the same width? So we'll just start off with it being the same width. So let's just kind of keep it around there, which is sort of around there, which is around about center, I think, is it? Copy that and paste it in place. So that's Command C and Command F. And then we'll just transform and reflect on the vertical. And then we'll move that out. So I'm just going to make sure that that fits into that same space. So as you can see, this is quite a heavy piece here, which we will fix later on. So if we bring down our stem, keep going at a stem, I'm not sure it is a stem. Crossbar. So that's then our A. I don't like how heavy this area is. I'm going to cheat it a little bit by mixing these, but first we'll just take a copy so we've got something to go back to. It's always good to not destroy what you've done first, or destroy everything that you've done and then have to go back and do it again. So using the merge tool, is it merge? No, it's shape builder. Using the shape builder tool, I'm just going to capture all of this. And then bring that just up a little bit. The reason I've done that is because we want this area to be just to be a little less heavy, because as you can see, it's kind of dominant. It looks really top heavy. So just drawing this piece out, possibly to, no, that's too much. So draw that piece out, and then you can see that that's actually a much, much more well-balanced A. Cool. Grand. So that's our two glyphs. And what we're going to do here now is just center these up, perfectly center them, in order to then bring them into Glyphs app. So what we've got with this file is the rulers are set to 0, 0 on this point here, which is our baseline, and 0 on this far left corner, which means that we can copy. So Command C, go into Glyphs app, and that was the A that we copied. Double click into our A in Glyphs and simply paste, which is then going to paste it absolutely perfectly along that baseline. Now you don't need to worry about your side bearings just yet, because we'll sort that out when we come to sort all the side bearings. So for now, what we can do is just put in a standard 50 by 50 to center it up. Sometimes what you will see is coming through from Illustrator is that it will add in just an extra couple of points, and that's always indicated by these red marks. So what I do is whenever I bring a glyph in, I sort those out first just to make sure that I'm not forgetting anything later on. So there you go, that's the A looking great. So the next one, what we did was E, and we're literally just going to pop the A away, bring out the E, copy that, and paste that into place as well. So what I didn't do with the E is merge everything. And what that's meant is that we've got nodes left over, so each piece is a separate piece. Now you can merge them, it's not a problem, but I quite like keeping everything sort of unlinked where possible. It just means that if you want to then change anything within that glyph again, you can do. So just change that to 50 by 50, and there's our E. So you can see that quite quickly, going through your glyphs. Actually, we'll just copy that for safety. So you can see that quite quickly, just building glyphs in this manner and then pasting them into Glyphs App is extremely quick. So if we select all these together, double click, you can see that our font's starting to take shape. So I hope you've enjoyed this one. It's been really nice to show you how I get started with that initial setup of Illustrator and Glyphs App. The template is always key for when you're working with Glyphs App, because it just makes sure that you are not sort of fumbling about. It means that you can copy and paste from Illustrator to Glyphs App really easily, and everything's going to stay in the correct place as well. If you've got any comments, it'd be great to hear from you. Leave a comment below. And if you want to see more of this, why not consider subscribing? So I suppose all that's left to say is cheers, take it easy, and I'll see you in the next one.